Previously on the Homes and Construction Affairs show, we started on our series of firefighting. We looked at several stakeholders where we had a school, we had a firefighting and prevention institution, which is the fire brigade. Today, we have the fire extinguishers because everyone has been rotating on fire extinguishers. Join me as we talk to Doreen and learn more on how we can use fire extinguishers.
A fire extinguisher is a gadget that helps you or protects you to put off uncontrolled fire at home, at offices, at workplaces, wherever you are. We use this equipment to fight the fire or put off the fire that we have not created. The people or the sector that does the rescuing is the fire brigade. Fire brigade does the rescuing, Uganda Fire Brigade. I'll share the numbers of the fire brigade later. They are the ones that are responsible to rescue or to respond to a market, to a family, to a home, to a building in case there is any fire outbreak. To anyone out there, we as Uganda Fire Experts, we offer trainings on how to safeguard yourself from any fire outbreak. How are you going to put off the fire before the fire brigade comes in? Yeah? How are you going to evacuate yourself, to help yourself, to get yourself out of danger in case of any fire outbreak? And also, we are here as Uganda Fire Experts to save you the gadgets or the equipment to help you safeguard your homes from fire. You know, the good thing you came at the right person. Doreen Asimwe is the president of firefighters in Uganda. So I'm going to give you the right teaching about these fire extinguishers. UNBS has trusted in me to be the chairperson of all the firefighting companies in Uganda. So, powder, this is a powder fire extinguisher, and this small size, as you see it, it goes for the car. I cannot recommend anyone to have this kind of a fire extinguisher at home. It is a small quantity or a small weight of 1 kilogram. So this one basically was for cars. We are living in the 21st century where we no longer use water as an element or as a... These days we have electricity everywhere, and we all know in our primaries we studied that water is a bad conductor of what? Of electricity. So I wouldn't recommend you to use water on fire, let's say on an electric equipment. You cannot use water. So we call upon you to have these fire extinguishers in your homes.
What are the different types of fire extinguishers?
We have about 5 types of fire extinguishers. And these fire extinguishers fight different fires. People out there, they don't know the types of fires. They think every fire is a fire. Yes, it is a fire, but it has a classification. The water type fire extinguisher, which we talked about, which is phasing out, because now we have electricity everywhere. Everywhere, so we're phasing out the water fire extinguisher. So that one is phased out. It can less work in remote areas where there is no power, maybe in the northern region where there is no power, or in the, like right now, we cannot use it. We can use it maybe in bush burning, you know, bush burning, yeah. To put off a burning bush or a burning forest where there is no electricity. That is when we can use the water system. In places where there is no what?
Electricity.
Let's say in our farms, if our farm has gotten a fire, we can use the water. Even there are these big pipes of water, we call them fire water hose reels. I think you've seen them. Like they are red in color, and then they are, it's a pipe, it's a rubber pipe. So it's what we use in places without electricity, or in case there is a very huge, 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 huge fire, that a fire extinguisher itself cannot work. In the water, we've phased out the fire extinguishers for water, and I've told you the places where they can apply. But in our Kampala here, our city of Kampala, these are the fire extinguishers I recommend people to have. So we have a carbon dioxide, which is here. A carbon dioxide gas fire extinguisher. And we have a powder. This is a powder in a small size. And also this is a powder. In fire, we have color coding. Color coding. The way I told you about classification, we have different types of fires. We also have fire coding.
What do you mean by fire coding?
Like when you see a color which is yellow, you know it means this. When you know there is a green, it means this. When you know it is a red, it means this.
It also means something.
Yeah, before technology got improved, we had all the fire extinguishers in their color codings. We had the fire extinguisher all in blue, if it is a powder. If it is a CO2, all in black. I think you've seen black fire extinguishers. If it is a foam fire extinguisher, it all used to be in cream. And if it was a fire extinguisher for water, it all used to be red. So that for a layman like you should understand, in case I find this fire extinguisher, which type is it? Is it a powder? Is it a carbon dioxide? Is it a foam? And where am I supposed to apply such a fire extinguisher? But now, since technology keeps on changing, they said no. We don't stand all the fire extinguishers to be red. But we separate, or we describe them, or we make them unique with where the powder is written. Let's make them unique. You see where the powder is? It
yes.
is blue. So they made them unique in terms of branding. Let all of them be red, but we brand them differently. When you come to these fire extinguishers, a powder, it already has a background of powder. And a carbon dioxide gas, it has carbon dioxide as a background. I don't have a foam here. It will have a cream color, a cream color of foam, meaning it's a color for foam. It will have, instead of a black, the word foam, it is F-O-A-M, to be in cream. And then we have also the wet chemical, and their word is in green. The wet chemical, those are other sophisticated firefighting equipment that are very expensive, but sometimes we are unable to sell them here in Uganda. There are so many, I cannot finish them. We have also FM-200. It comes in fire extinguishers as well, and also comes in a system. So those ones are used in server rooms in big companies that have server rooms. So we have that type of a fire extinguisher or a fire extinguishing agent called FM-200. Yeah. But right now, for primarily, what a home must have are these fire extinguishers. Or look around these fire extinguishers. We have class A. I think you see all these fire extinguishers. They have class A. I have A, B, C, and the sign of electricity. So it has A, B, C, and electricity. So meaning this kind of fire extinguisher, it is big in size. It's a 9 kilogram, and this is a 1 kilogram. This is a 6 kilogram, and also have a 4 kilogram. So what do I mean by A? A are the dry materials. Dry materials. Dry materials, we have our wood here. We have our textile, the clothes we are putting on, our furniture, the plastics, something solid or soluble materials. We call them inflammable solid materials. The ones that lie in class A. And in class B, we have inflammable liquids. So the oil doesn't go in inflammable liquids.
Really?
It has another class of fire. We have petrol. Okay, when I say fuel, I can say petrol or diesel. All that is fuel.
Mm-hmm.
We have the oils, industrial oils.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And also our oil. Sorry, our oil also lies in the cooking oil.
Mm-hmm.
also may lie.
May come here.
Yes. Yeah. And we have inflammable, you know, this alcohol, the spirits. You know, nowadays in our homes we have whiskeys, those kinds of alcohol. Alcohol is also one of the inflammable liquids. Then we have paraffin or kerosene. There are so many other liquids that industrial liquids that burn. So, but right now, for the fuel, I can give you the petrol, diesel, kerosene, alcohol, spirits. You know, you have this sanitizer. Sanitizer is inflammable.
Mm-hmm.
We have sanitizer. Those are spirits.
Mm-hmm.
Spirits we put in our wound. Those are all inflammable liquids. So we advise you to have a fire extinguisher. Then we go to C. C, it means it is fighting for inflammable gases. That is where our gas at home lie now.
Cooking gas.
Yeah, the cooking gas, we call it LPG gas. The cooking gas at home, we call it LPG.
Mm-hmm.
In food, liquefied petroleum gas. So it's called the LPG gas. And in also gases, we have industrial gases like butane, methane, acetylene. I think you've heard on of acetylene. It is an industrial gas. And the butane is an industrial gas. Methane is an industrial gas. Those are gases you cannot find in our homes in case there is a fire that it has gutted a store of metals. Or yeah, so we call it class D fires. This sign here is another class of fire, which is called electricity, where now we have our computers, our TVs, our cookers, everything electrical. So under this sign of
electricity.
So you find these fire extinguishers I've put in front of you, especially this powder. You see this powder? A, B, C. Meaning it can fight all classes of what?
Fires.
It will fight all your classes of fires. However, this fire extinguisher CO2 won't fight a class called A. The equipment inside or the chemical inside is designed to fight a specific fire. So people out there hear stories that I used this fire extinguisher, it didn't work. Did you study the kind of fire we are putting off? If you get such a fire extinguisher and you're fighting class A fires, a class, it won't help. So let's first know the kinds of fire we are fighting. So that's why I recommend every home to have this powder fire extinguisher. It is messy. It will leave the residue behind. It is dirty. We call it a dirty fire extinguisher because when you spray it here, you shall all run away from this place because it will leave the residue behind. But however, it is very efficient. For a home, let's say it's a three-bedroomed house, we normally recommend it to have 4 fire extinguishers. 2 inside, 2 outside. Why? We have one for the kitchen, which is the carbon dioxide, according to the classification of fires I took you to. We have this one, CO2 for the kitchen. And then we have the powder for the bedrooms or the dining or the sitting area. Then we have the 2, maybe outside the house, for rescue, for response to help. Because we in fire or in safety, we don't allow all fire extinguishers to be enclosed in the house. Why? Is because if we enclose them, but if you're closed inside, how will someone outside help you? So we should have fire extinguishers outside at the same time inside. If you're inside and you encounter fire, it is safe for you to put it off. If someone is outside and has seen a fire and you haven't seen you inside, that person can. At least you should have the 2 types. Have the powder and the carbon dioxide. The powder will go for the sitting room, for the dining, for the bedrooms. Then we have our clean fire extinguisher here, which is called carbon dioxide. We call it a clean fire extinguisher. It will go in the kitchen. It will put off electrical fires, okay? And it won't leave your place messy. Because everyone knows that most of the foods we take, they are preserved by carbon dioxide. So it is safe to use a fire extinguisher of carbon dioxide and eat the food. And even you can continue even serve the food to the people. So it is a very good fire extinguisher. It won't poison your food. You continue serve it the way it is. That is good. This is for the car. This is for a home. This is for a home. This is for a home. Now, like primary schools, the kids are a bit not energetic enough, so they can either use a 6 kg or a 4 kg. So when it comes to those high schools, universities, those tertiary institutions, they can use the powder. It is enough for them. It is portable. We call it a portable. It is portable for them to carry and put off the fire. We have automatic fire extinguishers, but we normally leave them in isolated places. We recommend them in isolated places, like a store. Let's say a home has a store, and this is a place where normally no one enters. So we have an automatic fire extinguisher, which we press on the ceiling. It has a ball, like I'm actually, maybe before the end of the session, I'll bring one here, and then you see it. It has a matchle on it, which senses the heat, and that heat must be above 60 degrees. 60 degrees. So
after 60 degrees, it becomes a threat.
Yeah, that is very hot. That is when it will, actually even the flames have come. That is when it will put off the fire. We don't recommend the automatic fire extinguishers in our homes. Why? Because there are always people. Why would you wait for the house to reach 60 degrees? Whereas you can put off fire when it is still a smoke. Because we say that these fire extinguishers are best used, you see the best results when you discover a fire, when it's still on smoke, when it's just a smoke, when it doesn't become a flame. Yeah, when it becomes a flame, that means the fire is huge. And if you have such a small fire extinguisher, it won't help. It won't help. They will only help you when the smoke is beginning or when the fire is beginning. And that is the mistake people do. They wait when the whole thing is on flames, they start calling fire brigade. In fire, we say when you discover a fire, when you discover a smoke, immediately tackle the fire. Fight the fire. Don't wait or you're waiting for it to have flames. Put it off there and then. So in most cases, people wait. A store is getting on fire one by one. So that is when they remember to use a fire extinguisher. And a fire extinguisher doesn't fight a big fire. First of all, the distance matters. And when the fire is too big, fire extinguisher should be big enough as well. So let's say a boda is on fire, because I encountered a scenario recently when a boda was on fire. He never had anything to use. He cannot put water. Good enough, I passed by. I had a fire extinguisher in the car. I helped him to put that fire. So you can imagine. If I wasn't there, because it was already covered under flames, you would lose the boda. At least you have a few things to repair than losing the everything. We have what they call smoke alarm detection system. Smoke alarm detection system. This is a standalone. We put batteries inside. This smoke detector will help us to detect smoke and make a noise in case of any fire outbreak. This one is battery operated. I'm going to sound how this alarm or how this sound will go in case of any fire outbreak. So it will make such a constant
noise. Like sound.
And it will be beeping. It will make that sound. Other maybe big buildings, you've seen these big buildings like Acacia Mall, like Arena, they have those systems where all the things are wired within the building. And you've seen this kind of equipment on the walls. This is a fire alarm detection that has this, has a smoke detector, has a sounder, and are controlled by a control panel. This is a standalone, remember I told it uses battery. But there is that one, that it is a system, the way we put electricity in this room, and we have bulbs and switches. When you want, you switch on, and it is controlled by a power supply. So this one also has a power supply or a control panel where the sound or the system will efficiently work. So we say in case of a fire, you press here, you break the glass. When you break this glass, there will be a sounder. A sounder will make noise and notify there is a fire outbreak somewhere. Then it will be your responsibility to check in all the rooms or in other sophisticated systems. That panel will show you where the fire is coming from. Let's say a big building like Acacia, it will show you go on floor, on ground floor, on this shop number, this, it is where the fire is coming from. So as how it applies in our homes, if you can afford, have a simple system like this, a smoke detector pressed in each room with a sounder. In case someone is sleeping and you notify there is a fire, you can sound so that everyone is alert to get out of the building or to get out of the house so that they are safe. We normally use this kind of hook. This hook goes here. You bring this fire extinguisher, you hook it from there. The reason why we don't put fire extinguishers on the floor tends to get cold at night or tends to produce out water. We call it moisture, it comes. And when the moisture comes, it will affect the fire extinguisher. For example, this, it will rust below. It will rust, it will start rusting because this is aluminium or steel. It will start rusting. When it starts rusting, it is going to create holes, meaning you're badly keeping your fire extinguisher. Yes, so it's going to create holes. In the long run, I'll tell you, I cannot service this fire extinguisher because it has what? Holes. You're going to buy a new one. This is for the case of the carbon dioxide gas fire extinguisher. Then for the powder, have you ever kept powder? It's really powder. Let's say like salt or sugar or posho, but this is a powder that fights fire, not the posho that we eat. It is just a powder that fights fire. If you keep it in a very long, in one space or in one position on the floor for a very long period of time, it makes stones. I think you've encountered that. Yeah. If you keep sugar, let's say in a tin closed, to put a spoon, you cannot even put a spoon. It has already caked. It has solidified. So we say this fire extinguisher should be hung on the wall so that it doesn't make those stones, it doesn't solidify. You get?
Yeah.
Once it solidifies, let's say you have encountered a fire, you cannot be able to use it. Because why? There is a straw inside this fire extinguisher that will pull out the chemical. But if it finds the chemical has already solidified, made stones, caked, the fire extinguisher won't be efficient. So that's why we hang them on the wall where they can have that that warm room temperature. So that in case of anything, it is
still ready to
be used. Very good.